Hello, comic book fans. Here's Earl Grey. Today I don't want to talk about classic comics, but about fine art, high art, so to speak, or rather one particular artist by the name of Franz Masariel, who is, I guess, of some interest for comic book fans. He was very well known for this strong black and white art, sometimes very beautiful, sometimes from a today's perspective maybe a bit aged, sometimes a bit naive in his political longings, because he always aimed for social commentary and had a political or social agenda, so to speak. He wanted to criticize a society of the society of his time. He lived from 1889 to 1972, and here you can see him doing what he did best: woodcuts, preparing some wood blocks. Why I'm showing you on one of these kind of videos that are usually devoted to comics? Well, I'll tell you. Here we have the self-portrait again, and this is one of his most famous works, Mein Stundenbuch, that's German title of course, My Diary, or the original French title was Mon Livre d'Heure, 167 woodcuts, published by 2001, German publisher, in 1978. I got it for a reduced price in the 80s somewhere, and I'm very glad that I have bought it back in the day. So this is what he did in this book called My Diary, a series of woodcuts depicting the life of a young man in the big city. He's curious, alone, amongst the masses, going his way, searching his way. We can see a little story unfolding, nothing spectacular, very easy to relate to, very easy to understand, not this kind of art that you need long explanations for, very decorative on the one side, and yeah, I always liked his stuff, especially this low-key approach. This is a little book. It's nothing mind-blowing, mind you, but it shows the simple joys of life, and this is some very heartfelt, naive stuff that I can really look at again and again and have my fun with these little books here. In a way, they are wise, in pretending not to be wise and not to be more intelligent than others. And there's no punchline or something like that, but a continuing narrative through this book here, and which makes it clearly a comic. Yeah, it's sequential storytelling. And one, yeah, I can't show you everything here, of course, because I wanted to give you an overview of his stuff here. Our young man obviously has something, some adventures to be experienced. Some carnival and some wrong ways and wrongdoings by him, and he's misguided. Yeah, some funny stuff here. This is called Story Without Words, and it is exactly that. Another one of Franz Masariel's Story Without Words. And this time he tells us a love story through all the faces, the good, ones and the bad ones. This kind of stuff here. Oh, poor boy. Another one of these stories without words is called Idea. Her birth, her life, her death. And that's an idea that goes back to the Greek, the personification of an idea. Here is a creator who has no idea, but then lightning strikes and out of his head a little idea arises. Hey, focus. So, and you have exactly depictions of this process of getting an idea from the Middle Ages or Medieval Ages. Mankind doesn't treat his idea always that well as she would have deserved. And maybe this is one of Masaryk's most cleverest stories he ever told. Prostitution of an idea. And they try to burn the idea, but she survives, even though her enemies look at the ashes and think they have won, but they haven't won, because eventually she will rule. And come back to her creator, but her creator has another idea. I think I haven't mentioned that Masaryk was a Belgian, and so no wonder he did some postcard views almost of his home country, and in this case of Antwerpen, big Belgian city. And he did similar things for other cities, for example Hamburg, of course, Hamburg. These are real, not so much about storytelling, but about depicting a city and what's going on in it. Or for an instance here, New York, but these are illustrations for a poem or a text of Blaise Cendrars. So, you have another example of his illustration work. Yeah. Here's one about the city. That's something else I really love. Here are the woodcuts a bit bigger, so you could use a bit more detail, and it's really mind-boggling how he put in all these details into piece of wood. Yeah, and there's a thing with these reproductions of woodcuts. They are not easily to distinguish from the originals. If you have seen some original woodcut print, you would agree that it's very difficult, at least on the first sight, to say if this is an original woodcut or a reprint, especially when it's printed on thick paper stock like it is done in this edition here. And I even got original woodcut. And I think you will agree that this differs not too much from the reproductions I've shown you before, generally speaking, even though it's very nice nevertheless to have some original art, an art print from Franz Masaryk within my collection, even though it's definitely not worth a lot. The way of humankind, or the way of man, der Weg des Menschen, again with this showing his social intent. And I think the woodcut I've shown you a second before, this original woodcut is a part of this series here. So his, let's say, leftist or even communist mindset made it easy for the East German government to use his, or misuse his art for propaganda purposes. But maybe it wasn't misuse because he was maybe fine with it. It was his political thinking that, yeah, he was on the side of the oppressed and the weak ones. But I'm very sure, because he strikes me as some intelligent man, so that I don't think that he was satisfied with the real communist politics. So, enough talk about politics, more about this stuff, because I think most of the fans of Franz Masaryk's art today like his depictions of this kind of stuff here, and that what's collected in this fine book here called Luster und Leidenschaft. This is a bit cheesecakey title, Sin and Passion, a bit uptight, so to speak, but nevertheless a very nicely made book. And in a very good condition. Where they had taken out pictures, theme related, everything, or a lot of the stuff depicting Franz Masaryk's pondering about sexual attraction, sexual attraction, I don't know, but stuff between man and woman and the sins, okay, and yeah, gluttony and stuff like that. Sometimes it looks, like I said before, a bit aged from today's perspective, but it's nevertheless a testimony to past times, a witness of its time. And therefore, even if we would do some of the stuff here differently today and are used to different ways of depiction, problems and stuff, it's nevertheless of interest, because it's there's a message in a bottle from former times. In case someone is still watching this video, I will show you pretty quick some of the other stuff I've owned. Franz Masaryk did a lot of illustrations for books. This is one from one Louis Fürnberg, The Feast of Life. One of these old books with very yellowed paper. And I like it when paper gets old. Sorry, but it shows the passing of time, and you can't have it with a new book. I digress, but maybe I can show you it with this one here. Engel, a collection of drawings depicting angels. And this is maybe as kitschy as old Earl Grey can get. But I like some kind of modern approaches to the old angel theme. And this could have been done easily by some beloved comic creator on a comic con. La douleur, der Schmerz, or the hurt, so the pain. And all these angels should depict some state of mind or something like that, but you can easily enjoy them without any thinking about anything. Yeah, destroying my books right in front of the camera. That's the Earl Grey style of making a comic video on. Another illustrated book, Fairfax. Yeah, this is maybe the most important and well-known piece of social commentary that he did. Fairfax is a book that was written by one called Sternheim and published in 1968. I would think that the original was way earlier. No, 1964. But here we have it. It's from printed in the German Democratic Republic. They obviously loved him because his criticism of capitalism and so on very fit was very fitting for their own mindset. But to be frankly, even where the communism has fallen apart and rightfully so, capitalism still isn't has his problems, no doubt about it. So, we have some problems to solve, and maybe his art is not as aged as it looks on the first glance. Here we have another collection of drawings, like this angel book, and here's a more freewheeling loser drawing in general. These are his more freaked out versions. Erscheinung means phenomenons and hallucinations, maybe. So, yeah. Back in the day, I grabbed everything what came to my under my greedy fingers. I go through used bookshops and thrift store books shops and so on, and I don't think that I've paid much for these because I hadn't much money. So I think it's okay if I stop here and don't overuse your patience. Thanks for bearing with me and for watching the stuff and for listening to my ramble. Thanks. Goodbye.